of 7 from the floor tonight. Nelson holds up for a fire.
You really get the feeling that each and every time in a WCC game, they could just dump it in the post to Karnowski, and he's going to score every time. As Goss has his first bucket.
I think they thought was going to be here for 3 or 4 years. And got so good so fast, he was done in 2.
Yeah, and he's just now, he's starting in the NBA.
It's on the season. Well, that's a tough shot by Haynes.
Yeah, tough to shoot that ball across your body like that.
Perkins with a penetration. Easy money for...
That's a heads-up play by Karnowski, stepping out and contesting the three-point shot that time by Brown.
Karnowski dumps it off to Collins.
Basketball for at least until the under 6. Maybe we'll talk food after that. Where do we go with Gonzaga in terms of their plays, not only nationally, but in the conference, very top-heavy with St. Mary's and BYU?
Well, look, I think you saw tonight, T.J. Haas at 20.
Zuzwa is as aggressive a scorer as you're going to see coming into this building, all freshman a season ago.
Great catch by Karnowski.
No good. That shot by Andrew Bastian, a senior out of Tustin, California. They just want to get him on the floor as much as possible. He has had problems getting healthy, staying healthy for the Wolverines.
Yeah, really athletic kid up front. Just can't stay healthy.
Again, look at that. Wolverine.
Just two. That one, and BYU hopes that will get him going.
Yeah, we saw that he was 0 for 4, and I'm not disturbed by that because they're good shots, and they're going to continue to run to him.
Karnowski lowers the shoulder, no whistle. Mika hits.
And Winston converts in transition.
So usually your Gonzaga team really takes its time and picks your part and tries to get that ball down inside low. You're going to get a lot of that.
So they've got some rangy guys as well, as the 6'11 junior.
He can do that at BYU. I mean, didn't take a lot, but 8 of 23 from behind the arc, he's got that range.
Karnowski in this ball game, right hook, no good from Zach Nelson. Williams ahead of Nelson. Nelson lost the handle, and they'll reset. And there's Karnowski! 2 hands!
Of the game. Hemsley gets inside, 2-0 Aztecs.
We've seen it already. Hemsley does an excellent job changing his pace, getting in the middle of the paint.
Izudu called for the...
Simpson's been playing extremely well as of late. 10 points, 13 assists.
And Zach Collins.
Shot from the elbow is off. Williams the rebound.
Yeah, he's a good player.
Yeah,
he's out of Burlingame High School in the South Bay area.
Karnowski.
Flying runner by Ray Bowles.
Tied at 17. Actually, Pacific now with a 2-point lead at 19-17. Tied again.
Amongst college basketball coaches. And Matisse Thybul, a player for the Huskies, who has had to deal with that as well.
Thybul lost his mother.
Not even in the top 10 in scoring for the conference.
Well, they don't need him for that. But he has mastered the game of decision-making. I like what I see with him when he comes down and makes plays like that, throwing it in the post.
Think about recruiting. They do have a good incoming recruiting class, top 20 in the country. But one of the adjustments for Simic Karnowski.
About it for a minute.
Karnowski is flush.
Oh, nice move.
You know, 8 feet, as you see the jump shot knocked down by Flack. Flack, Williams is athletic enough. Just take the shot at that point. Don't take the extra dribble to try to get to 6 feet.
Karnowski.
Knocking down the three on the other end to answer for the Broncos to make it a 5-point deficit.
We're playing against a team that has all kinds of firepower. Brownridge needs to have a big game.
Rattino has been playing extremely well with Renfro. Coach Smith is discovering who he can go rely on.
Now the inside press.
For it. They were on that possession. Good pass.
Yep, got it
so close to the basket. You just...
Minutes that he plays. I mean, he only plays 17 minutes a game. And he's averaging 10 points and 5 rebounds. That is extremely efficient. ESPN had a list of the top effective freshmen in the seat in the country. And he...
San Francisco still searching for their first three-pointer of the game. They shoot 40% on the season as Collins just slips inside.
Of course, I don't have the hair that Calvin does.
Great pass again by Williams Goss as Collins.
See Towns a little one-on-one. Nice left-hand jumper. Can't get the bucket to fall. But, hey, for I think that's if you can match up with Gonzaga as far as your physicality.
Karnowski and a chance for three in the
one-on-one.
He's a 60% free throw shooter. Hits one of two there. Karnowski now right back at Johnson. Left-hand shot up and good. Karnowski one of two. Gonzaga gave up a lot of offensive rebounds to Washington the other night. In fact, their most since the 02-03 season.
But he's regrouped, and coach said he's still only at about 85%.
And it's awfully tough to stop a play like that.
By Minlin went right through Matthews to score.
First bucket here, first 2 points for the Dons in the second half.
Williams Goss uses the screen.
He's got five. Williams Goss weaving his way inside.
3-point attempt short that time. That was Ray Bowles. Karnowski, and late to the spot.
In an atmosphere like this, communication is of utmost importance. And it should be the number one thing that should be happening on the defensive end. They should be saying, I help side, I got man. Pick coming left, pick coming right. But there's really none of that going on, and they're literally about 15.
Our two-man game with John Landale, and Karnowski takes it away.
Got to throw that ball up top. Bounce passes to big guys oftentimes don't work.
Jordan Matthews, one of the three transfers in the starting lineup for Gonzaga. Off to Karnowski, and it rattles home.
Opening round on Friday at Orleans Arena. Brett Bailey on the baseline can't get it to go down.
When you had Shemek Karnowski beat on that drive, I think he was anticipating that Karnowski would at least make an attempt to block that shot. He didn't.
Karnowski on the post up over the left.
In the corner, rebounded by Karnowski.
Once BYU misses, Gonzaga gets the ball up with 27 seconds left on the shot clock. So you have to guard without fouling for 24 seconds with ball movement and body movement.
Corbin Kafusi, the BYU football and basketball.
First start of the season with Nick Emery struggling with his health, having to deal with the flu.
When you miss against Gonzaga, you've got to get back quickly. That was a good job getting back.
Karnowski, double team. Extra pass, Perkins in the corner, buries the way up.
Hit that wall right there, Karnowski.
They had two other Bulldogs around him, too.
Nice pass.
Inside. His first points of the night. Here's Matthews from the top. Hits. Boy, players are
players in the country, period. At 7 feet. To have that mobility, that that dexterity with his hands and be able to finish that play with that kind of contact, he's big time.
Karnowski just kind of pulling his way down low, made it pretty easy.
Very often against Gonzaga. It's a 13-point Zag lead. Shemek Karnowski with the ball. And he's into double figures.
Under control. His last 7 games, he's done a better job of managing the team as a freshman.
Karnowski, too easy.
For the first time, friendly bounce from Trayvon Blewett. His first points of the night. Here's Matthews from the top. Hits.
Playing lights out. Last 5 games, 14 points. And he's shooting better than 55 from the field. And that's a good pick and roll play. You got Karnowski caught up. It's a nice job.
So they'll feed off the energy of this crowd just as much as Gonzaga will tonight.
Hermanson knocking down the three, and it's a 1-point lead for Gonzaga. Williams Goss comes right back.
Utah from Munich. That Silas in his offensive game isn't there on any given night. The defense is, and I tell you, when you have that defensive game, you feel like you're contributing at all times there, Shem.
Here's the back door. Georgievich scores for San Francisco.
Right on cue. There's a good example. When you're dribbled at, you automatically back cut. That time, Perkins lost track of his man, allowed the back cut.
Here's Karnowski. Left hand jump hook is
back. I think you become a broadcaster. Well, I love the conversation. Good matchup.
Williams backing in on Childs, and now it's.
And that ends a 12-1 run for GU. Here's Collins on the block, spins to the baseline. How easy is
Clara? He's got 9 points on his first three-point attempt.
KJ Fagan, obviously just getting healthy now, still trying to work his way back. He's only played in the last 7 games to an injury in the preseason.
Perkins trying to get on the board and does.
You got guys that can make that three.
Burton on a brick on the other end. This is Matthews, the Cal transfer, a sharpshooter.
He didn't have a good game in that game we had against Florida, but he's very capable.
Karnowski draws a double. Kick out pass to Matthews on a three, and he knocks it down. Last year's Big 12 newcomer of the year.
Yeah, he's a very strong, physical kind of player at 6'5", giving away a lot of size, doubling up on the basketball.
That leaves an open three again for Gonzaga.
Three again, so he's right there. Took a three ball early. And the Tigers with a 5-point lead. Williams.
Carter with a deep three, in and out. They are 6 of 29 now. It's right at 20%. Collins against Neubauer. Boy, the bigs pass well, don't they?
And Gates is on the board for the first time. Good action here. Good basketball game so far. Williams cross. He's got.
Lamont is so unselfish. He doesn't force his offense. He was 1 for 6 in the first half, but now he's come off with a fast start with 6 quick baskets.
Pick and roll. Good head fake by Karnowski. The big man puts it up.
Kentucky in 2015. Gonzaga trying to do it as well. Of course, a long way to go. They still have to go to St. Mary's on Feb 11. They have to go to BYU.
I think it's worth pointing out that first half, as great as Gonzaga was, Shemek Karnowski had only 1 shot attempt.
Santa Clara, 2 of 8 now from three-point range as they trail by 12. Here's Matthews, great backdoor feed to Williams.
Defensive minded.
So Gonzaga with Williams, Matthews, Williams, Goss, Josh Perkins, Shemek Karnowski is their starting five. Xavier with Trayvon Blewett, their star player. Makura, Jones, Gooden, and Bernard, who's already on the board with the first field goal. This is Williams inside. See this 2-3 zone of Xavier, and a little left-handed hook is good. He is a left-handed.
Deep three. Karnowski clears it. Shemek with 8 rebounds, 20 points. Williams already hit 1-3. You've got to defend it now. Karnowski. Williams!
Low-scoring affair so far in this one for a team in Gonzaga that averages over 80 points per game. Williams with the dump off.
Here's Shemek. Lifted for Matthews.
There are not many players at the college level that can bull Karnowski out of the way, but these two big fellas are going at it early, 3.5 minutes in.
Karnowski left it for Williams Goss.
Landale with a touch. Forced the pass. Williams Goss with the pick.
Of course, it's William Goss again. I mean, he left Washington. He was the one who's not sitting behind. A lot of times kids leave, they're all happy because they're not playing.
Karnowski, nice little flip over the shoulder there for Williams. And a cut, Melson, he'll draw the foul.
Offensive rebound, shovel pass. Leads to a steal by South Dakota in the second chance three-pointer.
Three-point game is Collins.
Close and see what they're made of. Close.
Gonzaga has not trailed in the second half of a game in 15 games, so they are not accustomed to playing from behind. As Nigel
stop over to Hawaii for a tournament.
then they had an 18-point lead against BYU in this building with a 99% pro BYU crowd, and they almost beat St. Mary's here as well.
And with the Lowski may have gotten a piece of that shot. Lowski goes to that. Lowski may have gotten a piece of that shot. Lowski goes to that.
Eric Mika trying to go off the glass. Mika averaging nearly 20 and 10 this season. His return from his LDS mission, where he spent 2 years between his freshman and sophomore year in Italy. That's the guard, Shemek Karnowski.
They're letting him play down low. I'm glad to see him let him play.
Nice feed by the seven.
Drive marks you crazy because that's what Kadeem Allen is looking to do. He's not a great shooter. He wants to get downhill and get to the rim.
Karnowski once again, this time with his natural hand.
Throw him the changeup and he makes it to the basket.
You're right. It was all about the hesitation he made. Karnowski just second guessed for 1 second, but gave him enough room to get to the bucket.
As we tell this Xavier story, and you're looking at two freshmen who have stepped up in big ways.
Handling the physicality, one-on-one, being able to not let Karnowski get too deep. I mean, he's fighting a battle there. I mean, he's undersized in terms of the weight department by quite a few.
Nice wraparound tap, pass.
Big reason for that. When you bring Perkins in the mix, it's going to be even more improved. But part of it, too, and I've been impressed right away. I was curious to see. This is a very unselfish group as Nelson knocks down another floater. Tough shot.
He wasn't expecting an upset, but we know him from his Pac-10 days. He was freshman of the year at Washington, then goes over to Kentucky, wins the national championship. And, man, we'll delve into it later on. But, my goodness, he's had some coaching experiences with some of the greats in the game here today. Nelson with the shot.
Tumbles to the floor but saves it.
And Mark Few said we don't have to double with the big guy. Such a big, strong, tough guy defensively.
Nelson.
Well, you said it, Bill.
You're right. It was all about the hesitation he made. Karnowski just second-guessed for 1 second, but gave him enough room to get to the bucket.
As we tell this Xavier story, and you're looking at two freshmen who have stepped up in big ways. And
this one in, and an open three is off the mark for Thomas. Thomas with 176 career three-point shooters. One of the more underrated players in the league. This guy's not underrated.
What a move. Stop and go from Wallace. Doesn't look to score all that much tonight, but we talked about it at the open, Dan. Over 1,000 points in his career. He can fill it up if he needs to.
And Matthews from the corner and the answer for...
Kid's the better shooter at all? Has that ever come up?
Jordan Matthews might be the better shooter. I actually had a discussion with Jordan about that today. He's probably the better spot-up shooter in his college career, but I told him I had a better overall time.
UCC tournament. This is only the third time these two teams have met with both teams ranked, and the first time since 2009. Williams-Goss falling away.
Well, shooting 30% over the first three games from the three-point line.
Shot way off by Brown. Matthews. Perkins. Melson three ball from the corner.
This great Sixers and Lakers as tip starts with NBA countdown at seven, charged by Mountain Dew. If you saw the NBA All-Stars reveal tonight, lot of heat going on with Russell Westbrook not being a part of the starting lineup. Harden and Curry are going to be in the backcourt representing the Western Conference.
Road anywhere, but in particular, if it's the number one team in the country, you're going to have to knock down shots, and you definitely can't turn the ball over.
Good cut and a slash by
side. Great anticipation by Thibel.
Known for his defense primarily last year as a freshman, Miles, but he's adding the offense. He's a double-digit scorer this year. Back door, and the wrap is good.
Lamar Johnson carries the straightaway jumper for two. They hadn't trailed in 13 halves, 266 minutes until last Saturday against Santa Clara. Santa Clara had a Nate Crash three to take a 5-4 lead, and that was the first time they trailed in a long time.
Going left from the top, the freshman from Estonia. I think when he gets it out there, you're going to deny the wings and contain him with your Gonzaga. Nelson, that's his second one.
By Marcel Petway, good offense by Bryant.
You get the ability to get in the gaps off the dribble penetration was very good. And then Petway, understanding there's a size difference. Get the defense up off the ground, get him off balance, then go for the finish.
Perkins.
You got to credit Casey Hill. He's done some positive things here in the first half.
He really has. He's been much maligned in his 4 years in the Gator program, but has stepped up here tonight. Perkins on a runner, and that's a much-needed
improvement from last year to this year. It might be greater than any player in the country. In fact, he leads the nation right now in player efficiency.
He already surpassed his point total from all of last year, and this is game number 17. There's Matt
hand in the cookie jar.
Yeah, you don't want to get a cheap one as a big fella. Those are the ones you cannot afford to get. The guards already, Xavier, are putting pressure on the bigs. Can't trust that happens.
Williams-Goss around and down.
It's Reyes. He's into double figures with 10, 6 rebounds, 3 assists.
He's going to be a big piece for them as Pepperdine moves further along in WCC play. He's a great addition as a graduate transfer from Utah for him.
Yeah, he originally committed to St. Mary's in redshirt.
I don't win 81% of anything that I do. Maybe the best attribute about Mark Few, loyalty.
Yep.
In a time where everybody's looking for the next gig in a major conference as Williams-Goss hits it too.
You had mentioned earlier, his shot is flat. He got away with
that
one.
And they've all hit the front of the rim every time. At that time, it bounced up off the glass.
They do that great.
Williams-Goss and the assist.
This is where you like experience. Somebody make it. Oh, got away with it, maybe. Williams-Goss!
Down, he had 9 points, 4 boards in 16 minutes in his freshman debut against Utah Valley earlier this week. There is Killian Tilly, so both the freshman centers in the game right now. Collins listed at 7 foot, Tilly listed at 6'10".
His rhythm just yet. And to your point, that was Collins on him. He should have driven him on that shot.
Now, Tracy reported before the game he was 100. He certainly hasn't been what we've seen so far in this tournament. Karnowski goes back out with it. And another shot passed up.
As Williams-Goss hits the floater.
He's trying to pull it up so you can't go. Brick two. Look at his free throw line. 1-5. Wow.
Williams-Goss, nice little teardrop.
They're going to have to feel pretty good about at least they haven't lost contact. And for Gonzaga, they'd get a bucket here. It just continues.
Toughness and rebounding, and he said, I learned patience.
Yep.
I've learned patience about myself.
Injury is one of the things a coach cannot control. Williams-Goss using that left shoulder.
Silas Melson. That's why people love you so much, Richard. The power layup, or no, just your sense of timing with your tremendous humor. Williams gone.
Good defense by Karnowski on the little guy, Fagan. And it's Perkins with the swipe.
That's a nice closeout that time by Hauser on the three-point shooter.
Karnowski inside, up with two hands.
Comes from San Diego, nice little drive. They picked it up the last two possessions.
Williams-Goss to back it away, the West Coast Conference Player of the Year. 16.6 rebounds, 5 assists. Giving it all net with a three.
They got to make the three ball. The only shot they got, Obi. The three ball has to be big for them.
Well, he had 16 in the quarterfinals against San Francisco. Williams-Goss really giving it up early, and that's leading to baskets on
Australia, who's the leading rebounder in the West Coast Conference and also averages 18 points per game. Williams-Goss will be picked up by Joe Rahon. Very important player for the Gales. Good backdoor cut. And the basket.
He's now 3-for-10 in the first half.
They're running that shot clock down to 5 with regularity. Backing way off of Zach Collins there, too.
Williams-Goss has been quiet in the first half. Finds Collins down low, and for the...
He hit that shot, hit the heel of the rim and went in.
Good L.A. reference. Arizona fans getting loud. Collins, good catch with the foul.
Clears the rebound, and Williams-Goss with the basketball. The lob again, Collins the catch.
Setting up the Gonzaga offense. Matthews can shoot the three. That one's too strong, but the offensive board to Jonathan Williams. He had 5 offensive rebounds against South Dakota State. The lob and the finish from Jonathan.
Well, Perkins can play point as well. It makes them a tough back court. Can't pick up your dribble against this defense. Look how they get right into you. Make you uncomfortable.
Nice score. Karnowski with the lay-in.
Short. Collins snags it with 2 hands. Williams-Goss trying to get away from Dozier.
This is a nice pick-and-pop situation and a duck in.
Williams-Goss, Karnowski.
There you go. That's exactly.
He'll talk to him about that. Just make the simple layup. Put it up on the glass.
Meanwhile, Collins shows you how to do it.
Defensive minded. So Gonzaga with Williams, Matthews, Williams-Goss, Josh Perkins, Shimmick Karnowski is their starting 5. Xavier with Trayvon Blewett, their star player. Makura, Jones, Gooden, and Bernard, who's already on the board with the first field goal. This is Williams inside. See this 2-3 zone of Xavier, and a little left-handed hook is
Flair to keep an eye on. And he said, Yoli Childs, he said he's an athletic freak with his ability to finish around the basket.
6'8", 225, local kid out of South Jordan, Utah. Williams, the turnaround, one of the 3 years.
And I use the correlation that it's the San Antonio Spurs. And that's a culture that's created by Mark Few and these players. And so you abide by that great move by Williams.
It's just in this league, it's nearly impossible to game plan for Karnowski. You can do some things, really focus on Williams-Goss if you need to. As
Collins steps down on Friday, all 15 coming in the second half. Surprise scoring for the Musketeers. Williams passes it up. Now he's on his way.
Has to run some clock here. Under a minute now. Shot clock at 11.
Taking the shot clock right there in his possession. You got to stop him here, though. You can't let him score. Take all his time off.
Collins straight on. Got it!
Streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN.
As good as this game has been, if you take Williams-Goss off the floor, you've got a better fair fight. Whoa!
The game of college basketball, and plus, your name ends with a beautiful A-E-I-O-U, baby. I'm Faison. Hey, Joe, all of us are not in the construction business. Some of us work for a living.
Just not you and I, that's for sure. Karnowski on the low block with a left hand for 2.
You saw Williams-Goss flying through there trying to grab the rebound. Williams strong. And he controls that loose ball. The Lions 4-of-17 inside 3. As Karnowski scores again, 2 more for the big. And Akron right now not getting it done at the free throw line. That could end up costing them. Williams-Goss, boy, Akron just clogging that middle up. There was no way to get that pass in there. Williams with a catch.
Herb Sendek certainly has them going in the right direction. And the administration is really looking at men's basketball to build it up again. Williams-Goss looking inside. Coming up with a 12-minute mark of this semifinal.
I wonder if Karnowski plays a big screen when he's up there on top.
Collins sets some impressive moments in this one. And there's another one.
He's an impressive moment.
Williams trying to get it back. Ends up in the hands of the point guard. Perkins. Gives it up. Karnowski. Got it.
That's what the
good one. This kid transferred.
He is 6'5", but he plays about 6'9" down low.
Almost had a backcourt violation right there. Moore came up over the half-court line and went back just in time to get it.
Back to a one-possession game. Open three on the way. Got it. That's
a good defensive team they are. In fact, what about this? Second in the nation in terms of field goal percentage defensively. Nobody talks about that. Number one, Johnny Dawkins, the University of Central Florida with the 7-6 tackle for a great pass.
Over the top.
It was high, Dan.
Well, you got Matthews is right there challenging it.
There's 10 on the shot clock for Josh Perkins. Wide open is Williams, another three on the way.
Out high to Williams Goss.
And they've been able to go side to side. That's why they're effective on the offensive end. Normally, South Carolina stifles you. Plus, they got this great target.
Wide open for the three. Yes.
Unbelievable.
Team wins, and they get you that win, and you didn't play well. You know you're going to show up for them next time.
Williams Goss played all but 2 minutes and carried a heavy burden against West Virginia. Scored 10 points, had 5 turnovers. Williams gives it up. Matthews for three, and they continue to fall. The long sleeve shirt on at this point. Unlikely he'll be coming back. If it will, it'll be as we get to the end of this half. 6:50 left. Here's Williams, the lefty. Knocks down a
And the 7th turnover of the game on the Aztecs. The steal inside by Collins. 10-point Gonzaga lead under 5 minutes to play here in the half. Nelson, the veteran, pulling it out and getting the high post screen with 10 on the shot clock. Matthews left alone. He's got 5 straight.
Set your defense. You're only down by 2 here with a little over a minute left. Big stop here for the Dons if they can get it.
Perkins into the corner. Williams Goss for three. Bang!
Second. A 4-week span where it's really some of the darkest moments of Karnowski's life.
About a year ago this time.
Yeah, about this time.
Alley-oop Williams back.
Very spread out defensively, and South Dakota State has been able to get drives to the basket.
Gonzaga went 2-for-14 from deep in the first half, shooting 31% overall from the floor. Perkins will try to change that in a good
read into that. Maybe not a guarantee they will get him back, but outstanding true freshman out of France. Lob inside to Williams. Nicely done by
Williams Goss with a great floater over the top. And the crowd coming alive here. An important time. Can Gonzaga distance itself from St. Mary's here with 6 minutes to go? Williams goes to his offhand, the right hand.
Raising his level of performance. They do a great job denying the post. I think he could curl and go opposite, get Karnowski involved.
Perkins dribbling around, looking for help. Bounces it over to Jonathan Williams.
And he's very good off the bounce, got the hook with either hand.
In the paint, little hook shot.
Jackson gets it back and will bring it back out. Zach Collins has checked in for Gonzaga as well, along with Nelson, who takes this jumper and hits it.
Example of that across the country.
There's a shot clock violation by St. Mary's. They had only 11 to shoot out of the timeout. The 4-point lead for Gonzaga. Matthews puts it on the floor, leans in, and gets it back out to Nelson. And Nelson.
And move. No wasted energy, no wasted motion. Knows exactly where he wants to go.
Almost unfair on the offensive end. Shemek's going to draw double coverage, but on the other end, defensively, he gets that one-on-one. Alberts from the free throw line is good.
From deep. A guy that shoots 34% on the season and averages almost 12 points per game. He has just 4. Perkins launches and hits it.
Steps and the shot clock is winding down and they're going away from that is exactly what you want to have.
Extend out your pressure, be aggressive. Gonzaga feeling very confident at that end of the floor right now.
You know, Sean, both you and I had some games of Williams Goss when he was at Washington. He was a good player then, but you can see that he's taken it to another level now, just his maturity.
Another 7 points now. This is as close as they've been since the game was 10-1.
You see the confidence starting to build in the Pilots, and in particular, Jazz Johnson.
Of the Warriors.
Much better defense on out of bounds under by St. Mary's than they ran in the first half. If you remember, Silas Melson on that same play got a wide open jumper in the first half.
Williams Goss, how good is that?
Karnowski tips it to Goss, who saves it. Nigel up the floor to Matthews. And the Lions doing a good job as you see them fronting Williams inside, guys.
Yeah, well, you talk to Gonzaga's staff, they anticipate the Lions are going to look to be physical. As Goss gets the nice touch.
Karnowski parting. Gets it to go, and that stops the run by Gonzaga.
He saved them yesterday, the other day in the second half against Vanderbilt. Had a great game in the lane. Not really a post-move guy, but getting better and better.
He had 14 and 11, Parton's fourth double-double of the year. Williams Goss, he's heating.
From three-point range for Santa Clara. They made three of their first four. Big reason why it was close in the first 10 minutes of the first half. Perkins lobbing, Karnowski off the glass and in.
Williams shot is short, Karnowski the rebound. Bounce pass, Karnowski.
Zag has always been that team over the years that's been under the radar, that has surprised people. Last year, a Sweet 16 appearance. 2 years ago, an Elite Eight. But this year, they're on everyone's radar is Collins. Off left.
Collins has 6 of those tonight. Perkins, good crossover. Collins beats the double team.
No, that's, I'm not predicting that at all, Dave. What I'm simply saying, that's how upsets
that's
happen.
That's the recipe.
Yes, sir.
Tilly with a hook for two.
Guys going to the NBA and graduating, and so they've had to integrate a lot of new pieces, but they've been experienced new pieces that Gonzaga has been able to integrate with Nigel Williams-Goss, with Jordan Matthews, guys that have experience playing college basketball at a high level.
Mid-range.
Jeremy Major, the school's all-time leader in assists, take that shot. Gonzaga still up by 6.
That was a classy moment before the game, celebrating Jeremy. Acknowledged before the crowd as the all-time leading scorer.
Alley-oop, Nigel.
This UConn team is probably like the 1970 UCLA team or something that people said, well, this is the year we're going to get them. And they won the championship in 70 with Wicks and Rowe and those guys.
Oh, jeez, are you kidding me?
Alzer one-on-one with Nelson, and Nelson wins the battle. Nice feed inside. Matthews with the
complaint is about not being able to touch offensive players.
Right.
Remember, defensively, it's supposed to be a hot stove. And that's it.
That's the case. You got a lot of burnt fingertips.
Thrown in by
paint and soft touch off the rim.
Oh, what a move by Perkins, getting rid of the defender.
The Pacific Tigers. Silas Melson moves in. Matthews has had a really nice game for Gonzaga tonight. Shot clock down to 7. Matthews fires, and Matthews hits him.
Of course, the winner will take on Iowa State in the championship game on Sunday.
Billy's brother, by the way, Kim played for the University of Utah. father's the national coach in volleyball.
Collins leaves it off for the sharp-shooting Matthews. Shot clock down to six for Williams-Goss. Step back. That's going to be a deep two.
Let's just put it in perspective. Just take that last drought that you just said. Couple that with the ending drought in the first half, which was 6 minutes and 24 seconds. You have over 17 minutes of play where you didn't make a shot. That's why you're losing by 30.
Williams-Goss just blowing by.
Will probably be better. You know, people might say, okay, Sane is better right now. Why put that kind of pressure on the young guy?
The fact of the matter is he's not.
You never know what's said right. Or not said, or what the running dialogue has been, or if there's been a warning or not a warning. So that's why it's hard sometimes to judge the interaction.
Rossi for St. Mary's tonight, keeping Landale in the game. He had a lot of foul trouble in the first game, only played 19 minutes.
And he picked up most of those fouls, Dan, on pick and roll situations, on hedging out. The ball handler just went right into him when he was the hedge defender. And so he's got to be really careful not to pick those up.
Nigel Williams-Goss, the transfer from Washington, who's not having
a game I want to see.
What's the game you want to see?
I want to see Gonzaga and UCLA. Want to see half of that. I want to see Nigel Williams-Goss.
8 respectively. Adrian, we talked about will Gonzaga be ranked number one when this week's rankings come out. You've heard a lot of critics say, well, they shouldn't because of...
Including St. Mary's can't.
They're starting that is that five, does their they, depth doesn't.
They don't have the depth, but they've got enough size up front to compete, and they're skilled enough, they shoot it well enough, where particularly down at Provo, it's the fact that they've missed so many shots. But at the same time, when you play against better teams, the habits that you have now, the way that you can dominate your defensive glass, that's created right now. You can't just turn that on. So I think that's got to be a real concern.
You got nothing out of Perkins tonight. You got nothing really out of Melson. Williams-Goss was basically himself, and they needed Matthews to come up, and he did. 25-point game now.
Zach Collins, nice move.
On. They beat him right here in Vegas in a shootout.
Look at the Gales now, second half, 6 out of 10, so they have picked it up considerably. Collins, yes.
I love that.
The lone undefeated team left in college basketball. Tied with Kansas for the longest win streak in the nation at 17 straight games. And off to their best start in program history with arguably one of the deepest teams they've had.
Kyle Clark with that basket, and now this jumper will rattle in. 80-49. And again, it was 27-25. Gonzaga at the half as Hachimura across the key.
Curious whistles that went against Gonzaga, and this is a veteran crew. They've probably had better days than they've shown us today. A three goes.
The students were able to check in and get to the game. Folks were critical of how quiet it was for the last home game for Gonzaga, but certainly a different atmosphere tonight.
Exclamation point.
Scored 16 points this half, 35 in the first half.
Gonzaga's defense has done a great job driving them into the low 20s.
Bang!
Well, let's see if they go high ball screen here for Nigel Williams-Goss. Try to get into the lane.
There it is. Karnowski just inside the line, and it works out.
At NC State, we talked about it. Coach James Harden at Arizona State. You know, watch out. There's some teams that I think are going to be.
That offensive drive that maybe was lacking last season ceases at points during the game.
And that's why a player like Malik Pope, who once again is missing this game, is so important. His athleticism, he's had a great offseason, his motor has much improved.
Jordan Matthews.
Blockers in the Big Ten, but he's giving up a lot of inches to Karnowski.
Northwestern did not have a block in Thursday's win. We saw Pardon there with his team leading 50th of the season. Just over 4 minutes in. Good start to this one. Williams-Goss.
Oh, here's Myers. Rises up high. And it's batted around. Ends up in the hands of Williams. And now Gonzaga wants to push a little. Williams-Goss back on the floor. The point guard for Gonzaga with four fouls. Matthews with four fouls as well. Williams backing in. Elijah Williams-Goss, tough shot. The fadeaway is good.
Whoever's hot, they continue to feed it, but it's also the offense. It's what predicates a good shot is the offense. How the defense plays you. They probe the defense for a backdoor cut.
Good ball fake and a tough one is the miss and the baseline for Anthony Towns for Pacific. And here is Nigel Williams-Goss. Matthews off the screen, the lob to Jonathan Williams and a slam.
Jonathan with five rebounds.
A nice effort too since the technical foul, 4 points, a couple rebounds. He's been a lot more active.
Big Jim. Left hand to a 9-point game with 7:04 to play first half. Perkins in the corner. Jordan Matthews. Karnowski, left hand good.
Opportunity buckets by an opponent. Another character there by Nigel Williams-Goss forcing it. 5 minutes left. You don't want to go into a stall game, but you want to be a little bit more conservative because you've struggled offensively tonight.
Just like that, back to single digits. 9-point Zag lead. Karnowski, left hand.
Lumpkins only hit 15 threes this year. And now Gonzaga will use a little clock as they try to get to the Sweet 16 for the third straight year. I agree. Where's Karnowski? Well, Collins has played well. He's got the ball here. Collins, tough shot. It's good. Wow.
Gonzaga has held Tennessee to 2-for-11 shooting. Tilly. Looking inside for Collins, nothing there. Here's Williams-Goss looking for an assist to Perkins. Got it.
Minute mark in this second half. That's an 18-point win against Akron at home this season. That is their closest margin of victory here.
Big job right now for Jordan Hunter, a sophomore, one of the seven Australians in the program, because Jock Landale is on the bench with four fouls in Karnowski.
Say, with Bryant, with so many young players on the floor, you got to give them credit. They have not played scared at all tonight, coming all the way across the country. Williams!
And I should say, young man, 18-year-old Domantas Sabonis. That's significant. He's averaging 14.7 and a half rebounds a game, even though he's a freshman. Wiltshire, the deep catch, and able to finish.
Three-point shooters on this team. Karnowski also at the scorer's table now, set to check in. Nice play.
Good pressure defense put together by Williams-Goss. Gonzaga, although they lead the conference in scoring, do not have a player in the top eight in scoring. It's Collins.
Instinct. And Tilly really has that in spades.
Final 2 minutes of this contest. Gonzaga wire to wire in this one, leading by 21. Nelson, the right-hand floater in the lane. Will wrap.
They had a meeting at Coach K's house, and they said, get out the practice court, take off the jerseys. And so this might jumpstart the second half of their season going into February.
Silas Nelson, you saw the grab.
On the defensive end now. That time, dribble penetration. McIntosh makes it all the way to the baseline, and Law floats out, makes the three.
Third three of the day for Vic Law. Williams-Goss for three. That's good.
Come in, and he'll have to deal with the big freshman Zach Collins underneath for Gonzaga.
Keep an eye on Gonzaga, trying to get points in the paint. Now that Mika's out, one of their best shot blockers.
Nelson, pick and pop, good head fake by Williams, and he throws it down.
And they're four of their last 15 from the floor. Loose ball grabbed by Perkins, bodies everywhere. The intensity is very high in this game. Important for both programs. Gonzaga trying to remain unbeaten, get to 10-0 for the first time since 1958. And Akron trying to sew up a win that would look great on the resume.
on the road. Perkins, Tilly, open three. Bang!
Come in, and he'll have to deal with the big freshman Zach Collins underneath for Gonzaga.
Keep eye on Gonzaga, trying to get points in the paint. Now that Mika's out, one of their best shot blockers.
Nelson, pick and pop, good head fake by Williams, and he throws it from three-point range for Santa Clara. They made three of their first four, big reason why it was close in the first 10 minutes of the first half. Perkins lobbing, Karnowski off the glass and in.
They want to make sure they keep Gonzaga away from the free throw line because they shoot 78% as a team and they get to the line quite often. Mike White told me before the game, we cannot foul and put them on the line.
Fading and firing.
And that's where Gonzaga's been going here last couple possessions. Santa Clara trying to make a little bit of a run. Gonzaga's been trying to counter that by pounding it inside.
Tilly the handoff to Perkins. As a give and go, Karnowski. Short jumper goes down for the senior.
He said, let's not talk about it till the end of February. So he's lowering expectations. But that's a good start for Reyes. They need him to be an impact player. He can get you 20 and 10.
Eric Rothman, Adrian Branch here with you in Malibu. Good pick and roll inside. Jonathan Williams with the left hand.
Grips this once. Stay at the Davenport, come to the kennel. May I recommend the spicy shrimp flatbread if you stay at the Davenport? It is outstanding. And tell Jen, who's back there at the Safari Lounge, I'll be there as soon as the game's over.
Williams underneath. Another terrific athletic.
And that's where Gonzaga's been going here. Last couple possessions, Santa Clara trying to make a little bit of a run. Gonzaga's been trying to counter that by pounding it inside.
Tilly the handoff to Perkins. As a give and go, Karnowski. Short jumper goes down.
Give the credit to the Zags defense again. And if you're Santa Clara, you're going to have to not turn the ball over.
Seven on the shot clock. Matthews feeds it inside to the big man Collins. Face-up jumper is good.
At home. That's amazing when you think about it.
BYU can really shoot the three when they heat it up.
One thing about Herb Sendick's kids, will play hard. They'll play intelligent basketball. But are they good enough to stay with this talented Gonzaga team?
Nigel Williams-Goss, one of the best players in the country. Down low for Karnowski, and that's going to lay in at 7-1.
Looking at the body language of Gonzaga, do they still have another punch in them? Do they still have another run in them? This is senior day. This is for an undefeated season. Of course, the number one seed is already secure in the NCAA tournament.
Good spin move by Karnowski. Orleans Arena just about full here for this third game of four at the Orleans Arena in the quarterfinals. Still to come tonight, the St. Mary's Gales, Randy Bennett's team, will take on the Portland Pilots, who stunned San Diego last night. Shima Karnowski
slows to within three.
Shot clock at nine. Perkins challenged, got it! Big time jump.
Two of those nights, he says we haven't had one yet, which is a perfect testament, not only to his players, but to Coach Few and his coaching staff.
Well, the consistency they've shown, and he mentioned that literally about the age of the players and the focus that they've had.
And I can respect that. You got a guy that goes for 47 and like a game goes down the wire against North Carolina. A fresh 33 on two occasions, 30 and a half when they needed him. I think he's just been unbelievable as a scorer.
And that's a great start to this second half for St. Mary's. These two big guys, Karnowski and Landale, are two of the 10 finalists for the Kareem Abdul-Jabbar Award, which signifies the best center
into your offense is going to be key, but he's got to be smart.
Tell you what, you nailed it. He's coming in right now.
So it may actually be if there's a whistle prior to the 8-minute timeout. As Williams Goss,
really good reps. He's just playing behind a guy that, if you're Randy Bennett, you're going to choose to play Landale the overwhelming majority of the minutes.
Bell shift. That's nicely
three. Jack Williams. It looked like with that shot, he had to put a little extra effort in it just to get it there.
That's his M.O.
21st three of the season. He's a guy who will step out and shoot it, that's for sure.
He's one of those guys who's better from the perimeter at 35% than he is inside the arc.
Matthews with the answer.
As we possibly can, but with him being back in the locker room, it might be a while until we find out exactly what's going on.
Ed Perkins, a 10-point-per-game scorer. He's one of their best three-point shooters as Nelson drives, gets high up in the air.
Pacific's confidence level will continue to grow, but, you know, this game is being played at Pacific's pace. Gonzaga needs to dominate the glass on this half, push in transition as well as create turnovers and get playing in an up-and-down style.
Shemek Karnowski, left-hand jump hooks.
And they usually do.
I guess the uglier the game is, the better it is for UOP.
I mean, sure, you just slow it down. I mean, keep possessions down. Don't let them get out on the break. But Pacific has a hard time scoring the basketball.
Jordan Matthews in the lane. And Matthews.
The home team has settled in. They're into this game now. The crowd is amazing. And now the game is slowing down for them.
BYU 4 of 11 from the floor.
Good defense. They're not giving up first shot opportunities.
Matthews calling for it in the corner. Silences the crowd.
To Key as well.
Both teams starting off a little bit cold from the field. 1 of 5.
I've been wondering Florida to beat a good team last night. That Singapore basketball team is very talented. Nice cut back door.
And a hoop in the horn.
This season, an exhibition game, toured for the third time, and basically that was his career. He had to end his career right there, just for his own safety. But his attitude after his injury was really inspiring. I mean, everyone else was so down, and he was the one that was up.
Karnowski, shot clock winding down.
Williams back up top to Perkins, who had the great first half.
It's that big screen from Karnowski.
Williams from 15.
But they have so many weapons, it was just a matter of time before a player or two was going to pick it up.
Sure. And it was really done with their defense, which is not a surprise. This guy right here, Jordan.
I did see it.
Williams Goss for three. It's good.
Of avoiding him for the finish.
He's got 16 tonight, Tosh. 6 of 9, he's knocked down a couple threes. Only player in double figures for the LMU.
And the lob. Here in the first half. At 37 in the Summit League Championship game last week. Tournament MVP. Williams Goss to the corner. It goes to Matthews. And Gonzaga finally has.
We are not going to win it in one possession with a home run play. Make the simple play. Move the ball side to side. That is so key, is giving the defense an opportunity to make a mistake.
Nigel Williams-Goss lobs it up over the top and scoring it is
Jim Calhoun. He was part of two national titles in 1999 and 2004.
Yeah, Coach Moore's got a really young basketball team in Quinnipiac, and he's going to have to really work hard and be patient.
On against to defend against.
And there you see the numbers. Akron doing a great job on the offensive boards. And we've got a 5-point game. Gonzaga with their first possession offensively in the second half. Josh Perkins, pick and roll to Williams, dives in and scores.
Let's see if the Zips can find an advantage on the low block.
And Karnowski goes out with 3 personal fouls, so that's a big foul early. 16:50 to play. Collins.
Jonathan Williams, and the Zags will start first on offense.
You'll see a San Diego team that is much improved from a year ago. Want to do a lot of the same things offensively and defensively. On the defensive end, you're going to see probably 95% man, and they'll double the post.
It really can't be overstated. The combo of Karnowski and Collins is so difficult, especially for an undersized team like Pepperdine.
Yeah, you can't cut everything off. I like the preparation that you have with Gonzaga. They're serious-minded. They respect the opposition. When they're back to work again, points in the paint.
What's it? Calipari. Calipari up by Zog.
Coach Cal might have his best recruiting class yet in Lexington.
Nelson.
Nice fake.
Great jump stop.
All this discussion of number one, you know who, what's no discussion? UConn is number one on the women's side. 91 consecutive victories. That is absolutely phenomenal.
Collins with a three-point chance.
San Diego State is coming off a year where they went 28-10 and missed the tournament. And a big reason why was their non-conference losses, especially at home. And it was the first time in 16 years as Collins gets inside for the bucket.
The track who's coming back from their missions, but Mika's back, a seven-footer that was tremendous as a freshman. They're going to have great shooting on the perimeter. I think this could be a year where you see three teams from the WCC go to the tournament.
Nigel Williams
at a 26% clip. It was really difficult for him because there was so much pressure. Here, he can take open looks and not have to force anything.
Jonathan Williams.
Yes. He'll have his place in Gonzaga lore. Third trip to the Elite Eight for both of these programs. Both trying to make it to the Final Four for the first time in program history. There is a lot on the line. In the corner, and Perkins drills right.
First foul called on number 14, Noah Robotham. It's been a well-played game, only five fouls collectively here with 8 minutes gone. Here's Melson, open three from near the top.
With the basketball, they work it around the horn. Eight rebounds now for Tilly in just 10 minutes on the floor. And here's Jim, right hand good, right over the Bulldogs. Nigel Williams got to bring it up. The Bulldogs leading by four, 10-6. Interesting to see Tilly working up high here. Perhaps trying to start up that high-low here. We'll see, that's exactly what they do. Now it's Nelson off the glass for two.
In Pavilion, where we're told it will not be a sellout here tonight. There are some empty seats.
Surprising. You mentioned in the open, another big-time college game just up the road, Oregon and UCLA.
Shimmick Carnell. But the ankle looks as close to 100% as it can be when you're playing here in early to mid-February.
Well, he put the Zags on his back in Provo the other night. Scored 33 points. Was dominant in that second half. That's just too easy.
They want to knock off the big guy.
Great point. This is the game of the year. But again, when we saw them come in the gym, they came in dancing where there isn't any music inside their head. They know they're good.
Good seal by Karnowski for his first bucket.
Where's the offensive answer going to come now from the Zags?
Well, I think you still want to get something going towards the basket. I would look for Zach Collins.
And how much do they miss Josh Perkins right now? Again, you were told at the half should return, and he will at the next dead ball. Shot clock at five. Again, the back down. It's Williams into the lane. Just rises over the...
They've held San Diego to one field goal, 1 of 14. Almost at home in the first half.
Those are some remarkable numbers. And the Zags have been awesome for about two decades. They've never had defensive numbers that look like that.
And with a left hand.
All over the Dons here in the first half. 27-16, Gonzaga on top. Eric Rothman, Adrian Branch here with you. Collins on the seal on the inside, and that play has been 3 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists. We will wait and see how much we see Nigel Williams-Goss tonight. It's Gonzaga in the white, Santa Clara, the Broncos in the black. Gonzaga has not trailed in the last 264 minutes of gameplay.
Well, this is the key matchup tonight, how they defend Karnowski down low in the block. He had a big game the last time these two teams met.
Matthews
on the year.
So our first turnover, and Gonzaga with another opportunity following that flush from J3. And now a little high-low. Shemek. Williams-Goss drives the lane. Hangs and hits.
Dan, about the transfers, I mean, this South Dakota ball club has three of their own. You know, Mooney's from Air Force, Dickerson's from out of Iowa, and then Hurst came out from Colorado State. So three big contributors that are playing for the first time for the program as Matthews.
Regular season.
And give some credit to Pacific, John, the way they played. Yes, Gonzaga wasn't in rhythm, but I think Pacific had something to do with
that,
too.
Junked it up a little bit. They threw some different stuff at Williams-Goss. They didn't turn it over.
Nigel Williams-Goss gets the roll.
So then he goes to Washington. It doesn't necessarily work out for him there. Although he had good numbers.
Yeah, absolutely.
But this system is more conducive, I think, to his skill set and the way that he can be able to play to his strengths, and he's taking full advantage of it.
Finding the open
balance that he thinks makes this team special. Maybe not the best team, maybe not the most talented, but certainly a team that can compete and go very far in March.
Yeah, I absolutely agree with that, because you don't have Wiltshire, who's going to score 45
tonight, and the next game it could be someone, a third person, leading them in scoring, and that's what makes it dangerous when you're looking at scouting reports and you're trying to figure out, okay, who do we key on when you look at Gonzaga?
Gonzaga only has one returner, starter from the last year.
Team.
Zags can get it back to double figures here. Karnowski, Williams. Spins, left hand goes.
Josh Perkins playing the point guard position. He's done so well in his time here with Gonzaga. Just behind teammate Silas Melson in terms of three-point shooting in the contest.
And I think Gonzaga's just been tougher defensively thus far in the game. And that's not something over the years in this matchup that you've said. You know, it's usually been Arizona's been the tougher defensive team, if you wanted to get technical about it. But Gonzaga, they have really been hard to score.
Again, Greg Heister, Dan Dickow, Richard Fox, and Josh Perkins with the basketball.
First 3 or 4 minutes here, Greg Karnowski gets the...
Well below his season average today, which is second best in the country. Karnowski spinning and scoring. Gonzaga trying to hold on and advance to the second round on Saturday against the winner of our next game between Vanderbilt and Northwestern. Karnowski powers his way for two. And Gonzaga will use some clock here as they inch closer to their 33rd win of the season. Only loss is at home to BYU as Karnowski is really...
And Enumanya, three fouls, two fouls respectively. Tough to go up against Karnowski with foul trouble.
Yeah, it is, and that's the problem area for them, and that was a problem in the last meeting between these two clubs. They really had no answer for Shemek Karnowski.
Goes up with the left hand that time.
Gonzaga. Karnowski calling for it. Draws the double. And gets rid of it with four on the shot clock to Matthews. A three.
16-point lead for Gonzaga. 3:50 now to play first half. Here's Karnowski. Poor Tyler Fleck. Double team kick out. Melson throws.
Off balance shooting that three right there. A little fake. Create some space. This is a special Gonzaga team. I liked them right out of the get-go, and I told you this even when they were down against Florida. They got all the components that you would want on a team. Look at that.
Oh, my goodness.
Are you serious? Are you serious?
And, but also, you know, Sabonis played in the best league in the world outside of the NBA before he got here. In a way, he was prepared. He was prepared in a way that most freshmen aren't. So his transition was a little smoother, and plus he wasn't asked to do as much.
Oh!
Williams gets the
can make from the floor.
And you see right now, Utah Valley's awfully comfortable. The pace of the game is where they want it. They're competing. You're talking to Coach Pope. He had no doubts his team would compete today.
Collins rattles that one home. 14-point Gonzaga lead. Skip pass. Matthews for three. It's good for Bulldogs working left to right on your TV screen. Nigel Williams-Goss running the offense from the get-go. Here's Williams-Goss getting ready to post up. Right hook will go, and there's your first point.
Up 10-0. Best start in program history. It's the first time the Zags have went through out-of-conference play unscathed.
first post up. This is the first time we're seeing him posting up.
Off the glass with the kiss.
Points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists tonight as Lamon Murray Jr. just 4 points in the first half, now 8 here in the second.
Lots of love about Lamon Murray. Does not take bad shots for a leading scorer.
3 ball. If you want to beat Iowa State, they got guys that can knock them down.
Williams-Goss with the response. My goodness.
Nearly a 7-minute drought for Santa Clara as Brownridge with the bucket. He's now into double figures with 10.
And he needs to have a huge game. He needs to shoot Santa Clara back into this. Even that, that's a huge shot from Brownridge, but it was contested. Very difficult shot.
Here's for Gonzaga. He is turning into a real player, isn't he, Dan?
I think the main thing he's doing, he's figuring out the ability of his to himself to shoot the ball as Nigel
Country. As Peter Herman continues a nice play tonight with a little jump hook to the middle. And he's got 8. No, that's a good point. I mean, they use up out of, what, 355 or 56 teams in NCAA, they're 350th in time of possession, so they don't shoot until...
In your class, that's 102 games over 500 in their career. It could happen. I don't think Gonzaga would pass Villanova.
St. Mary's able to get the switch, and Nigel Williams-Goss had to guard Landale. There is no way that he could keep him from getting the ball.
Perkins into Karnowski.
But to go back to Nigel Williams-Goss, that's one of the hardest things to do, is to be as consistent as he has been this year. Every game but two, he's been in double-figure scoring as Shevin puts up
along the way.
Perkins. Karnowski just using the body.
Del Petway. And that's a 16-point GU lead. No look. Catch by Williams. Spins. Bump. Sophomore.
Well, that's the only way it can happen. The 3 ball. The 3 ball is going to have to be really big for them. Can't wait to see Brownridge get going. Everybody raves about him.
Jared Brownridge, who is number 23 for the Broncos.
A lot of patience. Gonzaga usually takes good shots.
Williams back into the lane and lays it up.
High school. You know what other Arizona player went to Christ the King in New York? Keanu. Khalid Reeves. I almost said Keanu Reeves.
Well, we do have a Keanu in the game.
Keanu Pinder was just getting up, but it was Khalid Reeves.
Three from.
And found Lampkin for the easy bucket.
Lampkin with 12 points. Under 6 to play first half. Gonzaga with a 1-point lead as Williams Goss thought about another 3, and now Perkins will fire it. And he can.
He is 7 of 13. Matthews out of the double team, finding Perkins. So do you double Jonathan Williams? They decide not to.
Josh Perkins.
Right now, the opportunistic baskets have been all South Dakota State.
Collins will take the 3.
And beating away with 7 on the shot clock. Nice shot for a guy with the flu.
Well, he's got to make his possessions count because you don't have full strength.
Nelson circling the wagons. Nowhere to go. Kick out Williams-Goss. Another 3.
They want to dance with joy. The Zag fans are up. I mean, they're a little nervous right now.
Under 2 minutes to play here in Las Vegas. Williams-Goss. Yes!
Saw McIntosh out of that lane. Gonzaga limits opponents to 60 points per game. That's 7th best in the country. There's Williams-Goss. The jumper is good, and that's a good
record in an NCAA tournament is 12. What do you do? You pack it inside, or do you go protect the 3-point line?
You have to challenge the shot. They've been giving up open threes. That's what they have to do. Williams, who's a big man, got a wide open 3 from the beginning. But Gonzaga, 86 straight wins when they score 75 plus points. These guys get buckets.
Big men for both teams in a bit of foul trouble. Karnowski with 2 fouls gets.
Fulkerson is out for 6 weeks with that dislocated elbow. That hurts this team. He's had evolved into a starter for them. But let's also not forget Jordan Bone, who started 2 of the first 3 games as a freshman guard. So they've seen quite a bit of turnover in their rotation. Rick Martin's trying to figure out who are the guys that he can play.
Wow, tough shot.
Amazing job at Duke that season. Nigel Williams-Goss just having a different impact on this Gonzaga team. They're undefeated, as we obviously have talked about a number of times tonight. But his impact is felt in more than just the scoring column. Nelson with a floater.
He was just 3 for 13, and he has missed 8 of his last 9 shots. Figures to be one way back for Xavier. Gonzaga gets a second chance, and easy to the rim.
Yeah, scoring in 5 positions for Gonzaga. And usually the offense will get the best look.
Matthews, the head fake, beats Mika.
Trent Zachman, Ryan Keenan.
Let's see if this will get Pepperdine going defensively.
Gonzaga shooting 70% from the floor. Nearly 7 minutes into this first half. Goss goes right around the
defender. Good shot blocker. Josh Jackson, obviously a stud for Kansas. But Lonzo Ball has been a game changer for UCLA.
Karnowski to the left hand.
He's a good athlete. He's able to really elevate there. Nearly gets the finish over Karnowski.
And Killian Tilly back on the floor for Gonzaga. Jordan Matthews, Josh Perkins, Karnowski, and Williams Goss. And here's Karnowski. Inside Tilly, nice catch and finish.
Unable to knock down the jumper coming off the pick and roll.
Jonathan Williams now 8 points in his fourth rebound. Silas Nelson, corner three, good.
Possessions have been too soft right now.
How important is it for Coach Few down the stretch in the tournament to have two different type seven-footers as we see the
38 minutes a game? Every decision on the floor literally is run through him. To quickly adjust is going to be difficult.
Perkins.
So the word, when you talk about their facilities, their attendance, their national reputation, and of course the biggest one, which is their winning. Which is what Mark Few.
Robinson with 16 now. Gators up by 5 as we come up on the 12-minute mark of this game.
Every time they make that little run, they get back.
Karnowski on the drive. You better take it strong.
And they can wear you down with their depth. They really, you know, fatigue sets in late in the game.
Mark Few calling it the deepest team he's ever had in Spokane. Oh, nice look to Williams.
Great look.
A little pressure in the backcourt. LMU will change the looks up defensively. They'll give you a little three-quarter court trap action, a little run and jump. Make you think as a point guard what you're doing out there.
They've always been a very good offensive team. Tightening things up on the defense. This could be one of their better defensive teams.
Matthews spots up and hits.
They got a little more bounce to their step on the offensive end. Florida really negated their offensive strength in the first half.
Perkins.
Nelson for the lead. Got it.
Well,
I was a little taken aback
like
when Coach
Few said
that.
Dick Gow, when you had Pargo, and all of them had tremendous success. Blow by
Perkins. Excel.
Hey, I'm an optimist, fellas.
Yeah, you are. That's what we love about you.
Perkins, deep three. Inside 6 minutes to go here in the first half. The Gales by 1. Gonzaga got off to a hot start, but lately St. Mary's has kept this crowd quiet. That'll get him going, though.
Proportionately, I thought maybe he was dating one of the taller cheerleaders. He's married to one of the taller cheerleaders.
Probably 5'1".
Yep. And she was great, waving to us and
a little sweetheart.
Getting some camera time before the game.
What a wonderful young lady.
Williams Goss probing at the free throw line, leans in, tough shot for
organized, they've got good size, they're bigger on the perimeter than most WCC teams, and they're able to compete physically with GU in the backcourt, which has helped quite a bit tonight.
Williams Goss again bumped from behind, and he throws it up.
You know, watch out on the road, St. Mary's is a very good team. See what they did today, holding their opponent to 9 first half points.
Tilly with the slim hands.
On Karnowski, who just puts him to the deck.
And how well Arizona is playing right now.
Those other teams have a loss. You can make the case Gonzaga's schedule, the games they've played to this point, is equal to those teams. Now, by the end of the year, they'll be able to say they played a tougher schedule because of all the games they have in the major conferences. Karnowski to the left side, puts it in.
And for Mark Few. A 7-0 run. DJ Ursary, number 15 in for Pacific, along with number 35, Sammy Ellerackey. And the true freshman.
As we check in with Andy Katz.
Andy, you know, what do you think about the SEC, Andy?
This is a point that Mike White and I talked about the other day. This is how critical this game and this tournament was. They need wins against quality teams in November and early December. That win against South Carolina over Michigan was huge, and then A&M beating Virginia.
Offense, they always have a puncher's chance. Remember, they average over 80 points a game. Coach Rose, extremely successful. He is one of the senior statesmen in the WCC, and he instills confidence in these guys.
Matthews up with the left hand.
Good officials work there.
Yeah. 4-point game early on. Oh, Karnowski, great pass inside. And cut.
In the Summit League Tournament Championship game. And he's 1-for-3 from deep today, but they have not given him any space, even out on the perimeter. Great game plan by Mark Few. Williams Goss with a touch.
Wide open shot. See, now, if you're Mark Few, you want to make sure your kids play with the same intensity defensively. They don't get a little lackadaisical because of the big lead.
Karnowski really wants it. In close for two. That's pretty much it. Santa Clara sticking with Gonzaga.
Absolutely. I'm a little surprised. But it's only, you know, 10 minutes. They played tough for 10 minutes. And it's March. Anything can happen, baby. This is March. Miracles happen.
Williams Goss looking for the window. And
a talented athlete, big and strong. It's hard to believe he's 18 years old.
Yeah.
18-year-olds are different than they were 20 years ago. That's ridiculous. Look at that body.
You hear some Stanley Johnson in terms of physically ready to play as a freshman.
Look at that passing.
Matthews right down the lane.
Just beautiful. I mean, when the ball moves and you're,
he started at the start of the summer to get practice in, and as he shot more and more, he's starting to really get it down now, and he's got it. So now we just got to get him to do the other things, but I like the way he's rebounding, and he's got a chance to be a very good player.
You know, we saw the missed dunk and your reaction. What are you going to tell him about that? Maybe just lay it up.
I'm not going to tell him about anything. He went up to dunk with one hand. He has a bad right finger on his shooting hand. The ball slipped out.
Slashing guards. Gonzaga is going to have to do a much better job containing them as well as getting production on the offensive end.
And you talked about Wallace isn't a true point guard, but he's done a nice job tonight running the show for the Tigers. Only taking three shots, but he's been effective with three rebounds and those three assists.
Perkins for three. Right.
By the way, that last foul, that's one of significance for St. Mary's. Rahan just picked up his second. Melson.
So really talented basketball team Coach Pitino has. So. See what happens. Bigger game.
If you're going to try to stop him from getting to his spot, that's not going to happen.
Quick foul to start the second half. And that is exactly where
it's going to be. Gonzaga basketball. And Rui will be inbounding it. Here's Albert's short corner.
Post up on the right block because he wants to get to the middle and go to his right shoulder, left hand jump hook. So do you double team him? But if you do that, the problem is, look at these three-point shooters that they have.
Points, all of those in the first half. Perkins slings it right into the middle. And with a left.
The kind of game where he can run a transition. It's an open floor game.
Williams Goss spinning up with the
sides of the floor when you turn it over from the three-point line. Oh, falling asleep on the offensive end.
Williams Goss go. Six to shoot it. Here is Williams Goss. Silas Nelson moves in. The floater in the key, and he banks it in.
He's been a terrific player. He's only a junior.
Hermanson just picked up the foul.
Take him right now. He's got three fouls. Small.
And you can see how they're trying to play through him here in the early portion of the second half. A lot of times when a player sits on the bench for as long as he does, they struggle.
There's Karnowski.
Rebounds this half. Gonzaga winning the battle 13-5.
10-2 second chance points.
Matthews 18-footer splash.
Gonzaga trying to hang a third banner here in the HP Fieldhouse. They're undefeated in this event and a beautiful playoff.
His legs generate so much power on the vertical, and then he has a soft touch like his dad.
Matthew of six from the floor, finished after that six of seven from the field as he settled in. Alberts, the jumper is good from the elbow. Jared Stutzman has subbed in. He's a freshman out of Idaho Falls for Utah Valley. Alberts going right at the rack. To do
officials. He's an NFL referee when he's not doing this. Says he doesn't know yet whether he's working the NFC or AFC championship game. He'll know this week. Nice shot that time.
And that hurts. Towns has given you nearly a double-double over the last five games. 12 points, 10 rebounds. Matthews knocks 7 rebounds. Great rebounder for a guard. Averages 5 on the year.
Matthews open three. That's short. And he gets the bounce.
I wish we could see that again. What's the night before Christmas?
For stretches, it's been very difficult for Utah Valley to find good looks in their half court.
Matthews. Pulls a trip. Senior, you should know better than to put two hands on the big Shimmick Karnowski. He's trying to post up. Try to rule him out early, even though it's a mismatch. Don't get a cheap one. As
that about West Virginia, let me flip the reverse side. Gonzaga has made 577 free throws. Their opponents have only attempted 547. Here's Karnowski, little bully ball.
All Gonzaga people here at the Orleans.
It's all Gonzaga here in this early going of the second half. Pacific 1 of 7 from the field. Zags 3 out of 4. Make it 4 out of 5.
Shimmick Karnowski.